War of the Realms at number 4, written by Jason Aaron, art by Russell Dauterman. So this event comic continues to be very entertaining, very bombastic with its action, a real thrill ride of a story. There's tons of tie-ins. A lot of them aren't really too important. It varies, you know, it varies on what the tie-in is. But I know I've been really enjoying this series. Lots of pieces being juggled around, but continues to be a very thrilling event comic. So when this issue opens up, we are on Alfheim, which is the realm of the Light Elves. And Punisher has traveled through the Black Bifrost, and he is trying to recruit these Light Elves to their cause in their war with Malekith on Midgard. Apparently, the Light Elves were many years ago attacked by Malekith's Dark Army, where the Dark Army sacked the capital city, burned the gardens of the Fae, poisoned the Chardonnay River, and scarred the Queen Featherwine. And these Light Elves have been living in squalor and hunger ever since, but they are definitely down for some revenge on Malekith, so they are in. And Punisher, as a diplomat, is working, and he manages to recruit these people to their cause. Jumping over to Svartalfheim now, Freyja has killed some Dark Elves, and she is now wielding the Sword of Bitterblade. Similar to how Heimdall has the Sword of Hofund, the wielder of this Bitterblade controls the Black Bifrost. So Freyja is now in control of this Black Bifrost, and she tells She-Hulk to leave and go back to Midgard. She's no longer needed here. With this Bitterblade, Freyja should be able to fight anybody off. And, you know, She-Hulk can continue on the various wars that they need to continue on. So while Freyja is now controlling the Black Bifrost, she can start moving various Avengers and various allies to where they need to be. So now that they control the Black Bifrost, the various Avengers are traveling to other realms and trying to recruit Malekith's various enemies over to, you know, their own cons. Because Malekith has made a lot of enemies over the years. He's wronged various groups of people. So there are lots of people that would want revenge on Malekith. So going over to Nidavellir, She-Hulk is there. She's been transported through the Black Bifrost, and she recruits these dwarves to their cause. On Vanheim, Blade is there, and he recruits these Vanir gods onto their side. And going over to Niflheim, Ghost Rider is there, and he's recruiting these Guardians of Hell over to their side, aka these sort of giant spiders we see here. So, you know, all of these groups Malekith has pissed off, and they are now joining the good guys here. Now, jumping over to Earth now, Malekith has this Venom symbiote, which has now separated from Eddie Brock, which is something we've seen in the Venom comics, if you've been reading those. And the Venom symbiote is kind of out on his own, and Malekith has sort of managed to sort of like capture it in a way, and he's trying to tame it and harness it for his own means. So it's going to be interesting to see that explored over the next few issues. And then, jumping over to Avengers Mountain, a lot of the heroes are arriving back on Earth now using the Black Bifrost, and they are in this Arctic base. And there's everyone sort of recuperating. Now, Odin wakes up from his Odin sleep, and he is still injured, but he seems a little bit better. And he's asking where Freyja is. And the Avengers explain that she's still on Svartalfheim. She's defending the Black Bifrost. She has this, you know, Bitterblade weapon. And she will eventually destroy that Black Bifrost. And Odin wants to go help her because he feels, you know, it's too dangerous for her to do on her own. And Tony Stark anticipated that Odin would want to get back in the fight. So with the help of Shuri from Wakanda and one of the dwarves known as Screwbeard, Iron Man has built this hybrid Iron Man suit laced with Wakandian vibranium, and the reveal of this suit is super badass. So we see the Iron Allfather suit, and so cool. It's like all gold, and it even has like one eye missing because Odin has one eye missing, and super badass here. So Odin gets in this suit, and then Odin shows up on Svartalfheim to help his wife. Freyja is there, she's fighting. It looks like Malekith has shown back up on his home realm here. He has this sort of tamed Venom symbiote as a weapon. And, you know, he's sort of telling Freyja that, like, you know, this is my realm. You're not going to control this, even if you have this Bitterblade weapon. He starts attacking her with this Venom symbiote. Odin's now in the mix. They are all fighting through all of these people. And Odin and Freyja sort of make one final last stand here, and they successfully destroy the Black Bifrost. We assume maybe they're dead, but we don't really know exactly, but they sort of leave it off there. It's a little bit ambiguous what's going to happen here, but you know, Malekith is sort of on that realm as well, so you know, what's going to happen with all these characters, we'll have to see, but pretty interesting and pretty epic last stand. Back on Earth, all the Avengers are arming up, deciding how to start tackling the many fronts of war around the planet Earth, and what they're going to do from here. And since the Black Bifrost is closed, Malekith can't reinforce his army, and his armies on Earth can't sort of retreat. So, you know, the pieces are all sort of in play right now. And this issue sort of ends with Thor now successfully back from the realm of the Frost Giants, and Thor is ready to lead people on this fight. And that is how the issue ends. And yeah, really fun stuff. Lots of great action, lots of pieces moving, fantastic time. I'm going to give this issue an 8 out of 10. It is just simple, great event comic fun.